Welcome to another Nature Discovery Screencast. This is episode number 4. Look over my shoulder and watch as I look for the pure beauty found in nature from the raw video taken on one of my photo walks. The date of this photo walk was September 9th, 2016. And the photo walk was in one of our Cabarrus County, North Carolina parks. Now, I've already set up the screen here as we have a lot to cover. What we're doing is we're finding the good video out of all the raw video, the video that we may use someday in a 30-second nature video or a longer nature video in the future. Let's go right in, and I hope you guys like butterflies because we got butterflies and a whole bunch of other pollinators today. This park had a long stretch of yellow butterflies, or yellow flowers that is, filled with the yellow butterflies and all other color butterflies too. So let's take a look here. We're gonna look at these pretty butterflies, and we're gonna just pick the good video out. These butterflies are just working these flowers hard today. Just love the way they move. Mark that as a favorite. Let's look for some more within the clip. Butterflies are flying around constantly, so let's put them in the clip and let's look at these beautiful butterflies working these flowers here. We have a little bit longer clip, so we'll mark that as a favorite. And out. Mark that as a favorite. So as you can see, what we're doing here is we're searching for all the good video, and that clip there is another one here. Find mark that as a favorite. Take a look here. What we're doing is we're looking for the favorites, so someday we can kind of look at just our favorite shots and decide what we're going to use in videos. So let's see here. Here's a beautiful little butterfly. Wind's blowing a little bit, so he's moving around, but I'm skimming through. If I go at slow motion, you really see the detail on this beautiful butterfly. I know when I'm skimming, especially with a little bit of movement, it jumps all around. Almost make you seasick watching the videos, but it's the quickest way of finding the interesting things like this guy here cleaning his face, moving his head all around, seeing the extent of the flexibility he has to move his head. When you're studying nature, when you're looking at photos, You just don't see things like that. There, he's got that little, I don't know the proper name for it. I call them their noses, sticking out in the front. But look how they can independently move them. Just things I find amazing here. Well, this whole video almost is a clip we're going to make as a favorite. We're going to change from a beautiful orange butterfly to a there we go. Beautiful little butterfly. So we just make it and out right there. Well, we do have the butterflies today. And we have wasps. I just love watching these, all these critters. This is my favorite thing, to search through video and be able to just slow motion anything I want to be able to see the action. Unfortunately, the action in this case is behind a branch, but let's see if we can find some of this guy's action here without the branches involved. I just love the way they work a flower, these wasps, and I love observing how they use their antenna. Again, with a photo, you don't see how they really use the antenna. And you can see he's searching around. He's on one side of the flower with his face in the flower, but is using that antenna to explore. That was a, I don't know if you'd call that ungraceful takeoff, but it was interesting. So we're going to make that the out, and let's go back to where we come in on him, get the camera set, make that the in, and call that a favorite. Let's see, we've got the same bee. It's just a little too much behind the branch there. I can't see his whole body. There, he's come more into focus here. Now, he's not centered in the picture, but when I do my short videos, it's possible to take video and crop it. So we can do a lot of things. Ken Burns effects to give the entire picture motion a little bit, the appearance that you're zooming in. Just beautiful process of taking off there. Oh, and flying around. Beautiful. I'm sorry, folks, but this is my favorite way of looking at nature. I don't know why I'm sorry. It's just so beautiful. A little bee flying around there. Really working that flower. Looks like we're going to get another takeoff. I like that little piece of video. Beautiful little butterfly. Let's see what he looks like when he's taking off here. These butterflies, the wings are always so different on the upper side than they are on the underside. So many butterflies sit and perch, so that you only see them, you only see the underside of their wings. And they have beautiful upper wings. You can't see it too much there, and it's too much motion blur, but you got a glimpse of the bright yellow that's in his, so we'll make that the in here. Just when I'm skimming through here, sometimes we see something. I'm going to just skim from here. Sometimes interesting video can include photobombers. There's a little bee photobomber here somewhere. I've observed these in the past, that these little bee photobombers will oftentimes come into the picture, look at the butterfly, turn around and take off. Add some interesting dimension to the video sometimes. So we're going to just find our out point there. The yellow eyes on that butterfly. Just amazing beauty found in nature. And other beautiful flowers, beautiful butterfly. Butterfly's missing a little bit of its right tail there, wing. The little lobe at the bottom there. Well, let's see what we got here. He flies off. Kind of a good video of the process of working the flower. That's fine. Make that the in. Work the flower, work the flower. Gonna take off. Call that the out, and we'll make that a favorite too. So what we're doing here, we can look at the favorites and see that we're starting to get a collection of just the better parts of the videos here. Okay. Now, it's the bee pollinators. The bees turn pollinating these flowers. Bees, bees everywhere. Bee is a bee. But in studying these bees, it is amazing the variety of bees out there, and the different kinds of bees, the different patterns of colors and shapes, and just amazing. And it's one of the things I like studying. And we've got a photobomber here on this flower. There's a little worm, a little caterpillar, a little something just hanging out next to that bee. He's kind of standing up on one end there. No idea what he is, but we often find photobombers. Let's do his fly off here. Okay. And let's see what we got here. See what I mean? No two bees seem to be alike. This is a hoverfly. Don't know enough about them either, but I know there's a lot of different varieties of these guys around too. Just amazing critters here. Just love it when you can see them actually sucking up that pollen that's sitting on the end of these little flower stems. He's got this flexible hose-like vacuum cleaner, and he just sucks up that pollen. You can see the pollen actually disappearing off the top sometimes as he's doing this. Just amazing little critters. See, he gets done doing his vacuuming. Gonna clean himself up a little. Make sure he gets every last bit of it. And these guys seem to have short little tiny antennas that are oh my. This hoverfly is small. This thing is really small. But talk about small. Here comes, I think it's a woolly aphid they're called. They sit on the stems of and branches of, you know, vegetation, and they suck liquid out of the vegetation. And it actually comes and lands on the hoverfly's back. And then takes off again. Well, we're going to mark this one up as a favorite. Ah, now we have another wasp, totally different looking wasp than that other one that we had just seen, though. Wasps spend time, in my observations, going from flower to flower, doing the same thing the honeybees do and the butterflies. But they spend an awful lot of time cleaning up after themselves. They don't like pollen on them. They're forever cleaning up. This guy's got long antennas and using them. A lot of motion blur there. He's not the prettiest looking thing in the air. Can't see the detail. So we're going to be able to use the whole thing right up to about the point where he's gone. Okay, I call that a favorite. Well, let's see what we have here. We have a very bright yellow flower with a very dark colored skipper butterfly. It's hard to even see the detail in the butterfly because the camera is getting so whacked out by the bright yellow. But look at the length of that guy's, I don't know, I call them tongues. I know there's a proper name for it. And look how he's working it. Let's look at that in slow motion. Just working every little nook and cranny, and the dexterity he has with that long, long probe there. And the muscles that must be in that allow him to move it so delicately, and the ability to, is he seeing to probe around like that, or is he strictly feeling to probe around like that? These videos create questions that I just have never been able to find the answers to. That's why we love studying the nature, isn't it? Let's get, okay, camera set in point. We're getting lost in the nature here. He's got flower or plants moving in front of him. It's not the best video. There's another little one of those woolly aphids landing on the flower up there. These skipper butterflies are some of the smallest butterflies around. They're not very big. See the size of that woolly aphid there, you realize the differences in size. And the woolly aphids are just so small to study, you need a microscope to be able to see them clearly. My camera is just incapable of getting in there to do that. All right, let's mark this up. Back, the butterfly's back. Beautiful butterfly. This time it has a lot of blue in the tail. Start right about there. There's an end point. What detail. Let's look at what he's doing here. And I say he, not knowing whether it's a female or male. Without a little bit of study. Usually with the butterflies you can tell the females from the males, but takes a lot of expertise and a lot of memory, which I seem to be lacking in my old age here. Beautiful tail, his head moving back and forth as that tongue of his goes in there. A little bit of another fly out of focus flying around there. A little bit of a bug in that flower right where that butterfly's probing too. You're just going to work that and work that until he takes off. Now when you're looking at a butterfly like this, you can't see it too much in this video, but they have the appearance of having a left and a right wing because they hold them so together. But you'll see in some of the videos of the butterflies as they're flying, they have a set of upper wings and lower wings. So there's actually two wings on either side. And with some butterflies, you can really see that use of the upper wings as their primary wings. All right, let's find the end of this beautiful little shot here. He's gone. We'll call that a favorite. And we're right back on the next flower. He's in focus. When's he going to be in focus? Right about there. We'll call that the end. Just working those flowers. These screencasts get a little bit long. I just don't know any other way of showing you some of the beauty in the butterflies here, short of doing these long form videos. I have always concentrated on trying to create 30-second videos out of these, but the ability to go through and look at these beautiful, beautiful creatures and be able to go back and forth and observe what you really want to take a closer look at is just it's the reason why I'm into this type of photography. So many photographers, they're looking for that perfect still photo of this butterfly, but they miss all the action. I guess that's the That's the goal, is to capture the action in a single frame. But I'm sorry, folks. You can't really see what's going on until you look at slow motion. Slow motion video of beautiful, beautiful butterflies. All right, getting carried away here with the beauty of it all. Let's concentrate on working some of these up so we can produce some video from it. You can see the whole butterfly behind that flower, but it's an interesting little shot there. Beautiful. What do we got here? He's just got too much covered up by a leaf in the foreground. I don't know what kind of flowers these are either, but they're very, very tall, 6-7 feet tall in places. And it took a summer's worth of growing until we saw the flowers pop out in September. But it drew these butterflies in it. It's a very good close-up of that head. Transition there, but now let's watch this in slow motion as he's going to give us a peek of his underside here. You can see his body bit out of focus wings, though, but interesting. Good little shot there. You can see him as he's fluttering around the edges there. All right, let's see what else we've got here now. Okay, we got the same kinds of butterflies, just a little further away now. What he looks like taking off here. There you can see the underside of his wing a lot better. The shape of his body, the stripe, black stripe on his body. All right, let's mark that one as a favorite. Here we are back again. Look at the blue. Alright, so a couple little amazing clips there. And let's find them in focus again. Let's go down. Let's see what we've got here. All right, let's see. This one, focus. See anything? I'm just gonna. So much good video here. Let's take another. This one we have marked up. All right, mark that as an in. See the blue in his tail? Make that back to our little, look at the fur coat. This guy is wearing a beautiful little fur coat. Just working that flower, working that flower. Let's see what he looks like as he... Up go the wings, they start flapping, and away he goes. Call that a favorite. Same bee, different flower. Get him right about in there as he starts. Flies off screen. Do we get him again? Nope. Now we're chasing around something here. We got a couple things here. A snout. Nose butterfly. I'm not sure of their names without doing my research. So in these screencasts, I don't identify too many things here. Do we see him fly off? No. Camera moves because there's something better to take a picture of. Something that's actually moving. So we got a little clip there, and let's just call this the out. Some of these clips we're just going to turn into photographs. Pictures of the ground, pictures of a daddy longlegs on a beautiful little flower. Are we going to see him do anything though, or is this another photo? I think it's another photo. Let me just go in and out and save that to create a photo. Here we're back to our snout nose butterfly. Love the way he just folds those antennas up right along the edge of that snout of his. Very on colorful underside of that butterfly. Let's mark that as a favorite here. Now we have a skipper butterfly. Two kinds of skippers that I've seen. They're all the smaller butterflies out there in the world. But the smaller skipper butterflies, there seems to be two things happening with them. One is some of the butterflies work the flowers with their wings open. So you can see their wings. And there's a few species of these butterflies out here that work with their wings closed, like this one. And this shot, you can really see him working that flower and that tongue of his just going to town. Now the hover flies, just an observation here, were sucking up a lot of the pollen sitting on top of those dark brown stems, and these guys seem to work down in the nooks and crannies. They're going after the nooks and crannies. I don't know enough about this biology to sound educated. I just know it's beautiful to watch. Look at his wing vibrating there too. All right. Let's see where he flies off here. Maybe we can just get a glimpse of what his wings look like when he opens them up here. Nope. Moving too fast to really see. Make that the out here. And we'll mark that up as a favorite. Here we've got same critter. Some of the butterflies, those little points sticking out of the top of the head, I call the nose. There's all sorts of long fancy terms for them. These guys have short little ones there that you can barely see. That's cool. We get to see him roll up his tongue. Stow it away, fly off. Brought it back out, then he flew off. Let's see, up goes the tongue. He actually turns his head a little to see which direction he's going to go. And off he goes. Same little guy doing about the same thing. Make that the end. Do we see his wings better on this takeoff? Flutter, flutter, flutter. Never stops moving those wings. There we maybe a glimpse of what they would look like. Just too fast and too out of focus. Let's see. Fly off. All right. Thanks for spending time with me today to look at these beautiful creatures in their natural environment. Till next time.